I just want to offer a special welcome to people who are new to Anne's Place and participating in this Zoom workshop. I'm a clinical worker, so social worker at Anne's Place, and I also teach the midweek mindfulness, a weekly meditation and discussion class. I've learned a great deal from Cecilia Beach, who will lead today's workshop and whom I'm going to introduce in a moment. The title of today's experiential workshop is The Healing Power of the Breath, which is the title of a pioneering book by doctors Richard Brown and Cecilia and Patricia Gerbarg. When it comes to self-care, the breath is a resource that we often overlook. For many of you who are living with cancer or who have a loved one with cancer, anxiety is no stranger, nor is depression or fatigue. And making things harder still, the COVID-19 pandemic has spawned secondary epidemics of anxiety, depression, and post-traumatic stress. According to Dr. Brown, voluntarily regulated breathing practices, which we'll explore today, particularly when combined with gentle movement, have been shown to improve anxiety, mood, trauma, attention, cognitive function, energy, and social engagement, and also to reduce anxiety, fatigue, and hyper arousal. In short, these practices can help to improve mental functioning, soothe ourselves when we're agitated, feel safer in the world, and balance the nervous system. So the result is greater energy, resilience, focus, calm, stability, well-being, and even joy. So the techniques we'll be exploring today are derived from many sources, including yoga, Qigong, and Tai Chi. Breath, body, mind practices have improved the lives of people facing cancer, at-risk children, veterans, healthcare workers, active duty military, and survivors of terrorism, genocide, and natural disasters. Over the past year, I've had the privilege of attending a very refreshing, uplifting, and energizing weekly breath, body, mind Zoom class offered by Cecilia Beach, who kindly accepted my offer to teach here today at Anne's Place. Kind and clear in her approach, Cecilia is a level 4 breath, body, mind instructor and a Kripalu certified yoga teacher. She teaches at Alfred University, where she is also a professor of French and women's and gender studies. Cecilia has taught in the African Republic of Rwanda, working with students, the disabled, the homeless, and survivors of the terrible genocide in that country. So as I said, the workshop today is really experiential, and there'll be movement, there'll be breathing. If any of the instructions that are offered to you are uncomfortable or difficult, you can simply modify them to make them work for you, or you can just simply not do them, whatever works best for you. And then as was said, after we're finished with that piece of our program, we can open it up for any questions that you might have. So with that, I think I just want to welcome Cecilia, and would you like to take it from here?
I'd be pleased to. Thank you so much. Thanks for that wonderful introduction. I've so much enjoyed having Kevin in my class on Tuesday evenings. He's got this wonderful presence that, even though I only know him through BBM, I sort of feel like we're friends already. So, just as Kevin said, please make sure that you adapt anything that I offer. These are just invitations, right? So if I ask you to, there's a lot of arm movements, right? So if you have any shoulder issues or anything like that, or any problems with like lymphoma that might, you know, make it difficult for you to make these arm movements, you can always make them smaller or just do the breathing without the movements. That's always an option. A lot of the movement practice, I will be standing, but you are welcome to sit through the whole practice and just do the upper body parts if that works better for you. You know, we want this to be a beneficial practice, obviously, for you. So we don't want you to be in pain while you're doing it. A couple other things about this practice, and you know, just some of the things that I find so amazing about this practice. So the doctors who developed it are clinical psychiatrists, and they were searching for methods, you know, non-Western medical methods, right, that they could use with their patients that would be effective, that anybody could do, that you can do anywhere, and that are free, really, mostly. I mean, some people ask for donations in their classes, but or, you know, to do a training, you would pay. But these practices you can do anywhere, and they don't ask for special equipment. You don't have to wear any Lycra. You know, it's a great practice for everybody, for any age, from, you know, young children to elders. I mean, the people I worked with elderly genocide survivors in Rwanda, and they were, you know, elderly. You know, I'm getting to be that age now. So it's from 65 to 103, right, in my class. Some of them were in a wheelchair, and some of them were quite physically active. So, you know, anybody can be doing these practices. And I think that's just wonderful. They're also very simple. The first time you do them, maybe you might not find them quite as simple, but once you've done them for a few weeks, I would say that, you know, it's quite easy to learn the practices. So, you know, one of the things that's really important about these practices is that they balance the nervous system. So not only are they helping us to calm down, but they also help to energize. So it's finding that balance in the nervous system, the balance between the parasympathetic nervous system, which helps us to rest and relax and heal and sleep, and then the sympathetic nervous system, which helps us to act and to react, because sometimes we need to react, right? Sometimes it's called fight and flight, which to me is a little bit, I like act and react a little bit better, because, you know, we're not always going to be faced with saber-toothed tigers where we need to fight back, right, or flee in today's world. But in today's world, we are constantly, as Kevin was saying, bombarded by stressors, right? And with COVID, even more so. And so a lot of us are living in a constant state of stress. And these practices are so amazing at helping us not only to decrease the stress hormones, you know, which make us tense and then can lead to disease, but also to increase those good hormones, right? That help us to connect to other people, that help us to, you know, connect into those good feelings of love and connection, that also help us to the body to produce its natural pain relievers, which is incredibly important, right? In especially in your situation. So anyway, I don't want to spend too much time talking. I really want you to practice today. So put down your pens. You don't need to take any notes. This is for you, all right? I mean, if you're somebody who just has to take notes, that's okay. I don't want that to become a stressor either, right? but I encourage you to put down the pens. We do actually like, so I know that in the recording, you won't show up, but if you wouldn't mind turning on your videos so that I can sort of just see you and see how you're doing and see if anybody needs you know, special instructions or something, that would be wonderful. Yeah. But if you prefer to stay off video, you are also welcome to do that. All right. Everything is okay. If you are on video and you can adjust your camera so that you're sort of like me here, where I can see your chest and your face, that's wonderful. If you can't do that, no worries. Okay. just so that we can see how you're doing and I can adapt. Oh, kitty. Sorry. I love seeing cats on Zoom. All right, great. Pete, would you be able to mute everybody for the moment just so that we don't have any interference?
Yes, I'm just going ahead and doing that now. If you have it, if you can mute yourself, go ahead and do that. But if not, I am going through a muting, folks.
Wonderful. Okay, so we're going to start with some movement. And as I said, you can stay seated or stand up with me if you want. So I'm going to come and stand up right now. Let me put on my glasses so I can see. All right, so we're going to start with a few more energizing practices, or what we call activating practices. So if you want to stand, come with your feet just underneath your shoulders, planted on the ground. And if you're in a chair, that's fine. You'll see how you can adapt. We're just going to start to shake. Just bending the knees and letting the arms be loose. Now, if you're in your chair, you might be doing more of a handshake kind of thing. Just find some part of your body that you can shake. And imagine that you're just shaking off a first layer of tension. You're not trying to do it, you know, getting rid of all the tension at once, just a very first layer of tension. And if you have a lot of energy, of course, you could be jumping up and down and dancing, doing whatever you like. And then breathing. So make sure that you pay attention to your breath, feeling the inhale and the exhale. You might let the head move around a little bit. Maybe you shake out a leg, the other leg. And then let's come to stillness and just pause for a moment. And if it's comfortable for you to close your eyes, you can close your eyes. Otherwise, just gaze down and notice how your body feels now. Do you notice any changes? I'm feeling some tingling in the hands, for example. I'm feeling a little bit more heat in the body. My breath, a little bit deeper, a little bit more present, heartbeat. And my mind is more present, right? I'm more like on the present moment rather than thinking about what I'm gonna teach. Good. So that's just a little warm up. Our next one is one that most people enjoy a lot. We're going to get to dance a little bit, and it's called tapping. So we're going to be tapping different parts of our body. I'm going to put on some music. Kevin, how's that? Oops, Kevin, I don't see you anymore. Can you hear the music and my voice? Does it need to be a little louder, maybe?
You can take the music up a little.
How's that? All right, so just follow me. Just tapping on your side. And you can do this seated. And allow yourself to move to music. Same side. Up to the chest, under the collarbone. Open up my eyes and open up my mind, and I wonder how life will surprise me today. Back to the base of the neck. Early in the morning, it's the dawn of a new day. New hopes, new dreams, new ways. Shoulder, either shoulder. Open up my heart and I'm gonna do my part and make this a positive view. And then down the arm. Other side. Life is a challenge, not a competition. You can still smell the roses and be on a mission. Just take a moment to get in touch with your heart. And then back up. That was the belly. Up to the side. And then down the legs as far as you can. Down the ankles if possible. Up the feet. Inner angle. And then up the inner leg. Stillness. Close your eyes or gazing down. And again, notice how you feel in your body. Maybe there's places in your body that are more awake that you weren't aware of earlier. Notice the breath. Are you breathing deeper? Can you feel the heartbeat a little stronger? Notice the state of your mind and your mood. I think for most of us, dancing helps to improve the mood. And it doesn't take long, right? One song we did. And for me, that's enough to certainly make a shift in my mood. Good. Let's take a deep inhale, reach to the sky. And sigh it out. This is a good practice in itself, just breathing in and reaching, and then sighing it out. All right. Our next practice is called ha breath. So this is a great one for releasing any kind of negative energy that you've got. So anger, frustration, right? Fear. You can release a lot of negative energy through this practice. And so we're going to do actually two versions today of this breath. The first one, you take your hands to the sides like this. So your palms are up when you begin, elbows at the sides. And you breathe in, the elbows come back. And as you breathe out, you send your hands forward as if you're flicking water off your fingers like this. And as you do that, you say a loud ha. So this ha is coming from deep down in the belly. If anybody's done karate, you know what I'm talking about. This is a great opportunity to really make noise. Now, of course, if you're in a space where you can't make noise, don't. But in that case, you can either just go ha, like a loud exhale through the mouth, or a loud a strong exhale through the nose, like that. So if you can't make noise, fine. And that might be because of your surroundings, or because maybe you have a sore throat, or you know, whatever it is that wouldn't feel good. But I invite you, if you can, to really use your voice. Okay. The other great thing about this, it helps us, or at least it helps people in general, right, to find their voice, because a lot of us tend to be afraid of speaking out when we need to say something. So it helps us to advocate for ourselves and things like that. And it's energizing, all right? So let's begin. We're gonna breathe in like this and breathe out, ha! Nice loud noise. Breathing in, and out. Ha! 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 One more. Ha! And then pause for a moment and just notice the effects of this. So these different practices can be used in different contexts or all together as a whole. Sometimes when you just need to yell, right? Okay. So the next version of the ha breath is very different, you'll see. This one's called either love ha or heart ha. This was actually developed by children in a school because they were doing the regular ha breath. And then they said, but you know, what if we did it this way? And so it's become part of our regular practice now. So what we do is we breathe in love and then we send that love back out. And of course, we're not going to go loud ha. In this case, we're going to go ha. Right? So breathing it into your own heart. And if it's not love, maybe you're breathing in kindness. Maybe you're breathing in compassion or generosity, just whatever you feel like your heart needs, right? Make sure you do breathe it into yourself and not only send it out. I know a lot of people are used to giving, right? But you also need to nourish your own heart, all right? So let's breathe in the love or whatever it is you need and then send it back out. Ha. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in. Send it to everyone in the Zoom room. Yeah. Send it to all your loved ones. Your cats and dogs and fish and horses. And then send it out wider to your community. All around the world. How about to the earth? She needs it. Breathing in. And one more time to the group. And then coming back and just give yourself a hug. Give yourself a nice big hug. Maybe a little caress, a little pat. And then release the arms and close your eyes and notice. Notice how you feel after this very different version of ha breath. We're moving on to something called 4462. So we're starting now, moving away from the sort of more energizing practices into the calming and balancing practices. And 4462 for me, I would say is probably the most useful practice for me in when I get stressed out or anxious. So what we're going to do is we're going to breathe in for a count of four as we raise our arms up. I'm just going to come down so you can see what I'm going to do with my hands. My palms are facing up, but you don't need to get down. And then we hold the breath for four. And this is where it might be difficult for somebody with shoulder issues. So you can adapt. And then we breathe out for a count of six. So a nice long exhale and then pause at the bottom for two. So again, the arm movements are just like this, coming up, reaching the palms to the sky if possible, holding the breath here, coming down for a count of six, and then pausing at the bottom for two. So pretty simple arm movements. You can do smaller if that's better for you, or you can just, turn the palms up and then turn the palms down. So for example, if you want to do this, say you're going into a stressful meeting, right? And you can't be doing the arm movements. You could be doing hand movements underneath the table, turning your palms up as you breathe in, pausing for four, turning your palms down, and nobody would notice, right? You're just doing your own breathing and nobody will notice. So let us do it all together. Oh, just one thing about this. The extra long exhale is what's key to this. That's what triggers the parasympathetic nervous system. So that's what's triggering the rest and relax response, the extra long exhale. When you inhale, you're triggering the sympathetic. When you exhale, you're triggering the parasympathetic, right? So each breath, you're balancing your nervous system. It's a pretty amazing tool we've got within ourselves, right? All right, let us begin. Ready? Okay, breathing in, two, three, four, and hold, two, three, four, breathing out, two, three, four, five, six, pause, two, breathing in, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, breathing out, two, three, four, five, six, pause, two, breath in, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, breathing out, two, three, four, five, six, pause, two, two more, in, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, out, two, three, four, five, six, pause, two, last one, in, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and out, two, three, four, five, six, pause, two, release the hands to the sides. Close the eyes or gaze down and notice how you feel. Just take a moment. What's the difference? So for me, this is really grounding and calming. It's a great breath to do, as I say, in any stressful situation. I've done this with people who had stage fright, for example, for trauma. It's an excellent practice for PTSD, and somebody's kind of being triggered. If you can get them to calm down enough to be able to do the breath. And for my students, of course, when I teach yoga, I always do a lot of breathing in my classes on campus for the students. And they, at the end of the year, tend to say that the breathing practices are really what they're taking away with them. They love the physical practice too. I mean, it's a PE class. But the breathing practices are what they find really most effective. So it's important. All right. We're going to do one more movement practice, which is going to lead us into our core practice of coherent breathing. And I'll talk more about that when we get to it. But we're going to be moving now at the coherent breathing pace. Okay. It's very simple movements, just raising the arms up. And again, you can adapt it, right? As you breathe in and as you breathe out, let the arms float down to the sides. Very simple. Okay. So breathing in, two, three, four, and breathing out, arms come down, reach into the horizons. Breathing in, coming up, reaching up to the sky, and breathing out, let gravity pull you back down to earth, slowly, gently. Breathing in. And breathing out. Breathing in. And breathing out.
Couple more, breathing in. And breathing out. One more, breathing in. And out. And then just let the arms float down at the sides. Close your eyes one more time and just go inside and notice the physical body, the breath, energy, the mind, the mood. Great. So I invite you now to come to sit. If you have done this practice a lot before, I know I've seen some people I know in the room here. You're of course welcome to lie down and you're in the supine posture. Otherwise, I invite you to sit and make sure you're comfortable in your seat, feet on the ground, the back tall. It's okay to have your back against the back of your chair as long as you're not slouching over like this because you can't breathe. So nice tall spine. Hands resting comfortably on the thighs maybe or wherever it's comfortable. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing that same breath pattern, equal inhale, equal exhale. And it's 5 breaths per minute is the key to this. And we can talk about that after the practice. I don't want to talk too much now because we're prepped to go into the breath. But what we're going to do is I'm going to talk you through a gentle relaxation first. Then I will guide you with my voice into the breath. And then I'll be putting on some tones. There'll be rising tones and lowering tones. The rising tones you breathe in and the lowering tones you breathe out. And the tones will help you to gradually pace yourselves. And if it feels too slow for you at first, as it often does when you first start, don't worry, just do your best. Some people need to breathe in and then pause for a moment at the top and then breathe out and pause for a moment. If you need to, you know, pause and catch your breath at some point, don't worry, you're not doing it wrong. It's just your first time, right? It's like everything, you have to learn to throw the ball, right? So no worries if it's difficult the first time. All right, so let's take a couple breaths together, a couple relaxing breaths, those sighing breaths. So we're gonna breathe in through the nose and then sigh out. Breathing in through the nose and then sighing it out. And you might close your eyes or let the gaze drop so that you can go inside and start to breathe just slowly, but at your own pace. And as you do this, can you imagine softening all the muscles around your eyes, the forehead, those little wrinkles between your eyebrows. See if you can imagine those smoothing away. Softening the cheeks and the jaw, the tongue relaxing in the mouth. See if you can relax the neck and the throat. Softening, letting go. The shoulders melting. Softening. We carry so much tension often in our shoulders. Really imagine just melting away the tension there. And then down the arms, upper arms, lower arms, into the hands, fingers. Softening all the muscles down the back, all the way from the base of the neck to the base of the spine. The chest and the ribs, the belly, relaxing, letting go. Even inside, what if you could imagine relaxing all the internal organs? What would that feel like? And softening the muscles in the legs, the feet, the toes. Feeling your feet grounded, rooted into Mother Earth. We're going to start to breathe together now, breathing in slowly and breathing out slowly. Breathing in 2, 3, and breathing out 2, 3. Breathing in 2, 3, and breathing out 2, 3. Breathing in gently, softly, breathing out ever so slowly. Breathing in 2, 3, 4, and breathing out 2, 3, 4. Breathing in just a little bit at a time and breathing out, letting the air release gently and softly. Breathing in 2, 3, 4, and breathing out 2, 3, 4. Breathing in 2, 3, 4, and breathing out 2, 3, 4. Breathing in with the rising tones. Breathing out with the lowering tones. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathe in slowly and gently as the tones rise. And breathing out softly, softly, softly. In and gently out. In and out. You might notice as you breathe in, the belly rising gently, and the belly falling softly as you breathe out. No need to make it happen, it's natural. In, you're expanding. Breath out, a gentle, natural contraction. Breathe out again, imagining softening throughout the face. Relaxing neck and shoulders and arms. All the way down the back and the front of the torso. Down the legs to the feet. Each exhale, relaxing a little bit more. Washing away the tension. A little bit more with each breath. Continue breathing with the tones. If your mind wanders, no worries, just acknowledge the thoughts. When you notice that your mind has wandered, bring the attention back to the breath. going to use our imagination now to move the energy in the breath around in the body. It might feel like a wave, like a breeze, whatever works for you. So as you breathe in, imagine the breath moving up to the top of the head. And as you breathe out, imagine it flowing back to the base of the spine. Breathing in and up to the top of the head. And breathing out and down to the base of the spine. In and up, flow of breath, energy or color, whatever you imagine. And breathing out, flowing down to the base of the spine. Continue your own. In and up to the top of the head. And now all the way down through the balls of your feet. In and up from the balls of the feet to the top of the head. And all the way down through the balls of the feet. Out and down. Breathing in energy to every cell in your body. And breathing out, washing away the tension. In. And out all the way down, washing away whatever's not serving you. You might also imagine a gentle smile appearing on your face as if by magic. And again, when the mind wanders, no worries. Just come back to the breath when you remember. Back to the base of the spine, top of the head, and base of the spine. Now letting go and control the breath, just continue to breathe with the bells, the eyes closed, allowing your attention to go wherever it wants to. It might go to a place in your body that needs it most. Just breathe through that part of the body. Or maybe it goes to the heart center. Feeling the love, kindness, gratitude, passion. yourself and for others. I'm going to start to turn down the music now. You can allow yourself to return to a comfortable, natural pace of breathing, keeping the eyes closed still. And just allow yourself to rest. Letting the music move through you. Let's bring the attention to the feet. Can you feel the soles of your feet? Tops of your feet, toes, heels. Imagine your feet filled with space, light as a feather. Moving into the ankles, feeling the ankle bones on either side, tendon coming up the back, curve at the ankle, and up into the lower legs, and imagining the lower legs filled with space, up into the knees, backs of the knees, the kneecaps, upper legs filled with space, the whole of the feet, legs, spacious, light, airy. Coming into the upper body, feeling where your legs meet the torso, lower belly, upper belly, chest, feeling the back all the way from the base of the spine up to the shoulders, and all the space within the abdomen, chest. Imagine all those miraculous organs within, multicolored jewels of the belly, the heart, lungs, breathing. Every moment of our lives. Bringing the attention to the fingers, space between the fingers, palms, backs of the hands, the wrists, forearms, elbows, upper arm. Imagine the hands and arms also filled with space. Into the shoulders, the neck and throat. Feeling the space within the mouth, sinuses, backs of the eyes, forehead. Feeling the whole of the head filled with space. the very crown of the head reaching up towards heaven's space. Taking a couple breaths now, just becoming aware again of the wave of the breath. And notice how you feel. How do you feel in your physical body? What sensations are present? What sensations are no longer present? Notice how you're breathing. Maybe there's more awareness now of the pace, the depth, fluidity of the breath. Notice the state of your mind. Is it calmer, more focused on the present, or not? No judgment. Whatever you find is fine. And just noticing your emotional state too, your mood. Has there been any change? Let's start to move maybe the fingers and the toes. Maybe circle the head gently, gently. And if you like, stretching the arms. Let's take two relaxing breaths again together, breathing in through the nose and sighing out. Breathing in and out. And if you want, you can open your eyes. Just look around you. Try to find something beautiful. A plant, a friend, an animal, a picture, something colorful. And then look at the screen. Thank you so much for joining me in this practice of breath, body, mind. And I very much look forward to hearing how you feel before we get into the questions. If anybody would like to share, I guess we should stop the recording at this point.